up. It's hard to put that heavy weight over their head. Set yourself up for two more good chances.
Alexandra LaChance from the North Central region. She won that region, making her first appearance in the crossing game, and she will hit 185 in her opening lift.
And making that first attempt look rather easy.
To lane number 9, Emily Carruthers out of the Northwest this year at the 2013 Reebok CrossFit Games.
Strong lift. And made sure she got that okay from her judge before she dropped it. Smart athlete.
190 good. Now on to Reagan Huckabee. Lane number 11. Huckabee out of the Northwest region. First appearance here at the CrossFit Games, opening up at 195 pounds.
And shoulders.
And now to Amanda Goodman, 225 pounds for Goodman. Again, she won the clean and jerk ladder at the 2013 Reebok CrossFit Games. That's the last time at the games that we had a power event like this. And Goodman will get it, 225 pounds. So she is now your leader in this heat. Danny Horan in lane 14, 207 pounds for her. She takes her own headband off, getting it off her shoulders.
And Danny Horan, back in 2013 at the regionals, we saw her do 200 pounds for three. Surprised a little bit that she's
opening up at 205 pounds. Good lift for Rachel Martinez, 205 in the bag for her. And we'll go back now to Elizabeth Akinwale, who failed at her first lift at 230. Now she's going up to 240 pounds, so certainly not fazed by the fact that she missed that opening lift.
No, this is just showing her, proving that that was just a fluke, and now she's got it. She felt what that felt like overhead. She's going to focus here.
Elizabeth Akinwale hang squat snatched 200. And she will have it. Elizabeth Akinwale, 240 pounds on her next attempt. And she is your new leader in this heat. Now it's back to Wanda Brenton, who hit 145 pounds on her opening lift, now making a run at 155 pounds. Brenton cannot get that, so she'll be stuck at 145 pounds on the board. She'll have one attempt left. Gretchen Kittelberger hit 220 in her first lift, now going for 230 pounds.
And Gretchen takes a lot of time, a lot of focus to do, perform this squat. That's very taxing on the shoulders.
Kittelberger will get it, so she now sits at 230 pounds and in second place behind Elizabeth Akinwale. Nicole Holcomb, 196 pounds here. Again, these athletes can increase in 1 pound increments.
Little hitch there. Was able to push through.
196 pounds for Nicole Holcomb. Now Marlene Anderson out of the Asia region. She made 130 on her first lift, her second attempt now at 150 pounds.
Still with speed. Coming out of the bottom, she definitely has more in the tank. She should definitely make a bigger jump here in her last round.
And now it's Jen Jones. She had 215 on her first lift. Now 230 pounds for Jones, the former collegiate gymnast at Western Michigan. That one looked better than the first one for Jen Jones.
Yeah, it did. And you know, that's what happens sometimes. The first one is just get the nerves out. Once they have that feeling, that motor pathway, they know what their body's doing here.
Alexandra LaChance, her second lift, 185 pounds on the bar for LaChance. 196, pardon me, and that is good. She hit 185 the first time. So 196 now in the bag for Alexandra LaChance. Emily Carruthers hit 195 on her first lift, going up by 10 pounds. Good lift for Emily Carruthers. She will sit at 205 pounds on her second attempt.
And just like any other squat, the judges watching the athlete's hip crease get below their knee to make sure that they complete the full range of motion and then stand back up to a full lockout position with their hips and knees.
Michelle Kinney got stuck there, but she will make that count. So now 200 pounds for Michelle Kinney, making her fourth appearance at the CrossFit Games. Reagan Huckabee hit 195 on her first attempt. The athlete out of the Northwest region, now looking at 205 pounds.
And you can see this just struggle with some of these ladies with that weight overhead just to stabilize.
And that will count 205 pounds for Reagan Huckabee on her second attempt. Sheila Barden opened up with 200 pounds, now going for 216. Barden cannot get that overhead. She does, though, have a good score on the board, so she is okay. Now it's time for Amanda Goodman. Hit 225 on her first lift. Amanda Goodman with 235. That would put her in second place behind Elizabeth Akinwale in this heat. Amanda Goodman with 235 pounds to move into a solid second place in this heat behind Elizabeth Akinwale.
You see the strength in her jerk. She almost loses it because she has so much power going up there with that speed.
Dani Horan gets that one counted, 217 pounds for her. Finally, to close out round number two, Rachel Martinez, who hit 205 pounds on her first attempt, now going for 215.
So impressive. She weighs 130 pounds, Sean, one of her lighter athletes, and just making that weight look like nothing.
Third and final round about to get started, and now Elizabeth Akinwale with 251 pounds on the bar, her third and final attempt. She is already the leader in this heat, looking to add on to that total. Akinwale can't get it above her head, but she's still the leader. So one good lift for Elizabeth Akinwale at 240 pounds. Wanda Brenton going for 155 pounds again. Missed that on her second attempt. Looking to get it here on her third and final attempt. Just having trouble stabilizing it. She can't keep it up there. So Wanda Brenton will leave the floor with a score of 145 pounds. Now it's on to Gretchen Kittelberger, who has 230 pounds on the board.
And Gretchen is really able to do such a nice job of locking her shoulders in and keeping that midline so tight and stable.
Gretchen Kittelberger adding 7 pounds to her score, so she will finish up event number two at 237 pounds. Elizabeth Akinwale, though, still your leader here in this first of three heats, 240 pounds, as Nicole Holcomb looks at 206. No problem for Nicole Holcomb, 206 pounds, her final score in event number two. Marlene Anderson out of Asia, her final attempt, 165 pounds. That would count for Marlene Anderson, 165.
And you see, again, she looked a little conservative there with the weight. I believe she could have even gone another 15 pounds heavier.
Jen Jones trying to tie Elizabeth Akinwale for first place in this heat. Jones cannot get out of the hole, but she looked strong on the way down, but then lost it there as she sat at the bottom.
She did. It was that extra pause. She knew it. We just couldn't get out of the bottom.
Alexander LaChance at 211 pounds as Elizabeth Akinwale is still your leader. And LaChance makes that 211 pounds for the woman that won the North Central region. First appearance of the CrossFit Games. On to Emily Carruthers, her final attempt at 216 pounds. And that will count for Emily Carruthers, so 216 will be her final score after three attempts. Michelle Kinney, one last lift, going for 206 pounds. Kinney will get it.
Sideways on the platform, but she was able to stabilize and get that pause. Her feet were really wide that lift. I'm surprised she was going to fight to get out of the bottom.
206 pounds for Michelle Kinney, adding 6 pounds to her previous total. And now Reagan Huckabee trying to best that by 9 pounds. She'll go after 215. And that counts for Reagan Huckabee, 215, her final score. Sheila Barton, her final attempt, 216 pounds on the bar. Gets it overhead this time. And that will count for Sheila Barton.
A little redemption there. That feels good to end and make your final lift.
Elizabeth Akinwale looking on as Amanda Goodman trying to beat her by 1 pound.
And this is what we were talking about, Sean.
And Goodman by a pound over Elizabeth Akinwale is your new leader.
Goodman knows the field who she's playing against here, and she knows that there's not going to be many women that can do what Akinwale did at 240, and she didn't need to go big and miss it. Very smart.
Dani Horan now at 227. Does not count. She didn't get deep enough. You saw the judge make that wiping motion with both of his hands. That means the rep did not count, but Dani Horan still on the board at 217 pounds. Final lift of the first heat belongs to Rachel Martinez at 227. Rachel Martinez making that count, 227 pounds.
Almost 100 pounds over her body weight. Looked very strong doing so.
But it's Amanda Goodman by 1 pound over Elizabeth Akinwale. That's where the fractional weights come into play, and that's where going later in the heat is an advantage. Amanda Goodman knew the weight she had to beat. She knew she didn't need to beat it by more than a pound, and she did just that. So Amanda Goodman is your leader after one heat, 241 pounds. Gretchen Kittelberger finishes in third place. One of the prettiest lifts, but they counted.
Absolutely, and her strength is what came into play and why she's able to make these lifts. She's very slow on the descent and on the way up, but her stabilization of the shoulders is what makes for those lifts for her.
And Elizabeth Akinwale missed 230, went right up to 240 pounds, and hit this.
She had a little bob of it overhead, was able to get through this lift, made sure she made every point count for the range of motion, the full depth. Had a little risk, needed to risk it, but it was right here. Amanda Goodman, who was very smart, only adding 1 pound, knowing to beat, she exactly beat Akinwale, and she did so with ease.
Amanda Goodman is your heat winner, and she's standing by with Amanda Krenz.
Amanda, what was your plan coming into this, and did that plan change?
225, 230, so stuck with that, and then I just kind of made jumps based on feel. So I guess I stuck to the plan.
Made jumps based on feel, but were you watching Elizabeth Akinwale?
Oh, absolutely. There was definitely a little game to it. You always want to win.
And how are you feeling after the swim this morning?
Was definitely a little tired. Took a nice nap earlier, so that helped. But not so bad. I think we have a rest day tomorrow.
Yeah, pretty sure you do. Thanks, Amanda. Good job.
Thank you.
Amanda Goodman trying to win a strength event at the CrossFit Games for the second straight year. And right now, she is your leader, and she beats Elizabeth Akinwale by just 1 pound, and it's Gretchen Kittelberger who sits in third place. And these are three women who all needed strong performances in this event after what happened this morning at Hermosa Beach.
And this is the reason I love the games. Rules change. And every year, it's not just about how heavy you lift, but it's how smart you play the game. You heard her say, Goodman said, there's a game to it. There's a lot more ladies to go. There's a lot more games they're going to be playing.
The second of three heats in lane number eight, the two-time champion, Annie Thoris' daughter. We know she loves getting her hands on a barbell.
Absolutely, and Annie's strong. She did have a back injury, which we didn't see her last year at the game. She's coming back. Squats are not her favorite, but we'll see what she does tonight.
We'll keep an eye on lane 14 to Elena Fortunato, an injured quadriceps muscle. But earlier today, Annie Thoris' daughter did exactly what she needed to do. This was not necessarily an event that played to her strengths, but she finished well above the middle of the pack and set herself up nicely heading into the rest of the weekend.
She's a smart athlete, and she's just so athletic. She can pretty much do anything you throw at her. She'll try, and she usually will succeed even if it's the first time she's ever doing whatever it may be. But here, these are the movements. This is what she trains for, and this is what she's known for. Everything we're going to see that's the typical CrossFit overhead squat is nothing scary to her.
And usually smiling as she is there, Annie Thoros' daughter, missed last year's CrossFit Games because she hurt her back during the Open and was unable to compete after that. She has two championships under her belt, 2011 and 2012, looking to get number three here.
And you know what? Sometimes an injury, Sean, she's always a smart athlete. I mean, just pushed her body, never knew how her body could hold up with the capacity, the work capacity that she has, you know, and the volume she works. But maybe that injury may have made her even a smarter athlete. Maybe she even dialed in her technique even that much more. And I'm anxious to see what she does this year.
Annie Thoros' daughter loading her bar to remind everybody on event number two, pretty simple, one rep max overhead squat.
Yes, the women will each go on their own time, or every 20 seconds, one of the ladies, the next lady, will make a lift. They have three attempts to make their lifts. They're going to declare a weight, a starting weight, and if they miss that lift, they're not allowed to drop down. They have to try that weight over again, and there is the increment of 1 pound that they're allowed to jump, not a 5 pound jump. The smallest increment is 1 pound.
Emily Beers just saw her getting ready for her opening lift, and Annie Thoros' daughter continuing to load her bar. Emily Beers was on a team in 2011 at the Games, making her first appearance at the Games as an individual. The first lift will belong to her out of the Canada West region. She's going for 195 pounds. Lift. 195, the opening attempt for Emily Beers.
Nice strong jerk overhead.
And Beers got out of the hole, but then struggling there, keeping the weight overhead.
Unfortunate lift. She did move her ankle there. She has had a slew of injuries keeping her out of competition, and amongst them was an Achilles injury.
Lauren Brooks from the Southeast region, where she finished in third place, 195 pounds on her opening attempt. Not deep enough on that one. Had trouble kind of finding the groove there.
You know, surprising, Sean. 2013 at the regional, she was able to put up 180 pounds for three, and that was off the ground. It just shows you that maybe this morning's event really took a little more out of these athletes than we expected.
Mandy Janowitz also making her first appearance at the Games as an individual. 185 pounds, and she'll get it. Mandy Janowitz, the first woman here in heat number two to hit her first lift, 185.
I can't tell you how important this first lift is for your confidence. You know there's only three lifts. There's a lot of weights going up there, and it's really important to get that first lift for your confidence.
Emily Abbott, the woman who finished just ahead of Emily Beers in the Canada West region, she will hit 200 pounds on her opening lift. Tiffany Hendrickson opens up at 205 pounds. Henderson gets that, so she is now your leader in this heat at 205. Celeste Engelbrecht out of Africa opening up at 165 pounds.
Look, very easy. She paused down there for a heck of a lot longer than I like to do, but nice and strong on that lift.
And now, Iceland Annie Thorsdottir, the two-time CrossFit Games champion, opening up at 205 pounds.
See the nice big breath that she takes, locks down her core.
And Thorsdottir will get it on the board at 205 and tied for the lead here in the first round of the second of three heats. The second scored event here at the 2014 Reebok CrossFit Games. Alessandra Pacelli out of Northern California at 207 pounds. Got no rep right off the bat because she wasn't deep enough. Had a brief conversation with her judge. That will not count for Sandra Pacelli. Kelly Jackson, 180 pounds on the bar for Kelly. Good lift for Kelly Jackson, whose roommate and training partner, Alex LaChance, lifted in the first heat.
Kelly Jackson didn't even think she made it. She was moments and then minutes after the regional finish that she realized that she was going to the finals.
Becca Voigt, 200 pounds for the veteran. Becca Voigt is one of three people to compete in seven CrossFit Games, the only woman to do so.
And she looked very composed there. Great to see that from Rebecca.
Christy Atkins, also at 200 pounds, formerly Christy Phillips, got married recently, changed her last name. This is her sixth appearance at the CrossFit Games. And Atkins will make that one count. That's big for her because this is not her strength.
This is her Achilles heel. And Christy only weighs 135 pounds. Again, another light athlete. Very impressive to see her put those numbers without her first attempt.
Margo Alvarez from Northern California, 175 pounds in the bag for her. And now finally to Lena Fortunato. She has that right quadricep heavily taped. She was limping on that this morning. We will see how this holds up for Talena.
Oh.
And crumbling under that weight at 176 pounds. And it's not looking good for Talena right now. She needs to get a lift in the bag to move on here.
And if you can just see the pain on her face, that is very unfortunate for Talena.
Final lift of the first round out of Australia. It's Pip Malone, finished third in that region. She was 36th at the CrossFit Games in 2013. And that lift will count, 205 pounds. Three-way tie for first place. Tiffany Henderson at 205, Annie Thor's daughter at 205, and Pip Malone at 205. And now back to Emily Beers, who missed her first attempt at 195 pounds.
Hopefully she can ride off the momentum of some of these ladies and some of their bigger lifts. Going first is always a hard thing to do.
Beers has it overhead. Wasting no time getting into that squat. Struggled, but it will count.
She just looks like she's off. She's not very happy about what's going on.
The best list at the top of your screen, the leader will be highlighted in blue. Lauren Brooks missed her first lift. Now she's going after 200 pounds. And that one will count for Lauren Brooks at 200 pounds.
And you know, there's a sweet spot. Once you start descending in that squat, you either know if you're in the right path or if you're not. And it looked like she hesitated there, wasn't sure she was quite right, but was able to fix it.
195 pounds on the bar for Mandy Janowitz. She already hit 185 on her first of three attempts. This is attempt number two. The judge says it's good, so 195 for Mandy Janowitz.
Sometimes the angle that we're looking at is really hard, but the judges are watching from the side to watch the hip crease get below their knee for the lift.
Emily Abbott bags 210. Tiffany Hendrickson up at 210, trying to now tie Emily Abbott for the lead. And she will do so. So now it's Tiffany Hendrickson and Emily Abbott tied for the lead in the middle of the second round of this second heat at 210 pounds. Celeste Engelbrecht from Africa at 175.
She has great hip flexibility. She's able to get down there with great knee position and utilize all the muscles in her legs to get out of the bottom of that squat.
Annie Thoris' daughter hit 205, going for the outright lead here at 216 pounds. That will count for Annie Thora's daughter, and I was going to say you're going to see her smile if she hits this lift.
Definitely looks a little more cautious than we're used to seeing Annie lift, but again, she's happy with that and hasn't done a lot of heavy squats.
Now Sandra Pacelli, who was no rep on her first lift, no question on that one. 207 pounds for Sandra Pacelli.
With really heavy overhead squats, if that bar just pulls you slightly forward, it's hard to get that depth and to pull your butt back and down.
Kelly Jackson hit 180, going for 192 and cannot get it overhead, so she'll be stuck at 180 as she heads to her third and final lift. Now on to the seven-time CrossFit Games competitor, Becca Voigt, who finished second in the Southern California region and never had a finish in that regional competition outside of the top seven. This lift will put her in second place in this heat. Voigt cannot stabilize it, so she will be stuck at 200 pounds with one lift to go.
And once the knees cave, it's all in your quads. See if you can fight through them to get out of the bottom. So hard to do with that heavy lift.
Christy Adkins trying to move into second place with a lift of 211 pounds and pass Emily Abbott and Tiffany Hendrickson by a pound. Adkins will get it, 211 pounds for her.
Very impressive, but that's what Christy does. She can fight through and hold on.
Now Margot Alvarez, 186 pounds. No problem for Margot Alvarez, making her second appearance at the CrossFit Games. Talena Fortunato, Mr. First Lift at 176, needs to hit this one here.
To compensate for that jerk.
Fortunato, you just saw that leg buckle. I don't know how much she has on that with one lift to go.
And you know what, Sean? She's an athlete that's always said it's not worth it for her to hurt and wreck her body, and I'm wondering what's going through her head right now.
225 for Pip Malone out of Australia. Pip Malone is your new leader. 225 pounds for the woman from Australia.
She looks like she really knew what she was doing. Coming in with the plan to hit that 225 looked very smooth.
Final lift for Emily Mears, made 195 pounds on her second attempt. Now trying to close out at 205 pounds, but everyone's chasing, though. Pip Malone, 225 for her. Final lift for Emily Beers here in the second of three heats. Beers struggles through it, but she makes it count. Emily Beers, the good lift at 205 pounds on her final attempt. Now 215, final attempt for Lauren Brooks. And with that lift, Lauren Brooks moves herself into third place, just a pound behind Annie Thor's daughter.
For a lot of these women, just took that second lift, making it, getting the confidence that they needed to show us what they could put over their heads.
Mandy Janowitz, 201 pounds. And Janowitz, you saw her just start to buckle and couldn't hang on to it. 195 will be her final score.
And that's typically what happens. That's why it's so impressive when you see Christy Adkins and other women fight through that. When there starts to be a buckle and fight and pull it out, is so impressive.
Now Emily Abbott at 220, trying to get into second place behind Pip Malone. And Abbott almost had it, but just could not stand that weight up. So Emily Abbott will have a final score of 210 pounds. Tiffany Hendrickson out of the Southwest region on her third and final attempt, increasing by 5 pounds over her second lift.
Doesn't waste any time getting into that squat.
That will tie her for third in this heat. 215 pounds for Tiffany Hendrickson. Now 187 for Celeste Engelbrecht.
Oh, and just
not good.
Lock that out.
Not going to count. Yeah, she couldn't get that one overhead. So Celeste Engelbrecht, 175 pounds for her in the second heat. Annie Thor's daughter going up by 6 pounds, 222. That's move her into second place in this heat. She's chasing the woman on the left of your screen out of Australia, Pip Malone, who has the leading score in this heat at 225. And I think the back is okay. Annie Thor's daughter, 222 pounds, second place right now in this heat.
And he even holds that for an extra 3 or 4 seconds, just to make sure.
Sandra Pacelli, 217, that one will count.
Amazing fight out of the bottom there.
Moves her into third place in this heat. Your overall leader, though, is still Amanda Goodman, 241 pounds. Put that up in the first heat here at the tennis stadium at the StubHub Center in Carson, California. 192 pounds on the bar for Kelly Jackson. Jackson hits 192 on her final attempt.
Smooth squat.
Becca Voigt, 212 pounds on the bar for her.
She's going to keep those knees out this time. She does much better.
Great lift for Becca Voigt. She'll close out with a score of 212 pounds. And now Christy Atkins, who has a score of 210, going for 217 to tie Sandra Pacelli for third place in this heat. Has it at 217. It looks like someone has been working on her weaknesses.
So exciting and a good lift.
Margo Alvarez, 197 will count for Margo. Talena Fortunato still has yet to make a lift. 176 pounds on the bar. She needs to hit this.
The crowd is getting behind her. Lots of cheers going her way.
Look how she's favoring that left leg, but Talena Fortunato will get it. She is still alive in the competition. Clutch performance for Talena Fortunato.
Good for her. That was almost a pistol squat.
Now Pip Malone already is the leader in this heat, trying to inch closer to Amanda Goodman. 231 for Pip Malone makes it look easy.
Absolutely strong. That is her move.
And she gets the applause from Iceland Annie Thorisdottir, the two-time champ. That's good enough for fourth place overall for Pip Malone, but your overall leader remains Amanda Goodman, beating out Elizabeth Akinwale in the first heat by just 1.241 pounds. Still the top lift that we've seen all day as Pip Malone gets the hug from the two-time champion, Annie Thorisdottir. Definitely not someone we expected to put up big weight in this heat.
No, it wasn't. I mean, Pitt has great numbers. She really does, but I'm not expecting to see that. The overhead squat is such a strong lift. But Annie Thorisdottir here fighting a little bit more hesitant, a little bit more cautious than we're typically seeing her do, but she was thrilled with these lifts, was able to perform very well, even with that coming out of that back injury. But Pitt Malone at 231 was solid for all three lifts without a belt. That is her move, nice and strong. It was the hip flexibility, the flexibility, and the strength.
Pip Malone is standing by with Amanda Krenz.
Pip, when you heard that you were going to get to do overhead squats, what did you think?
I was really happy. It's one of my favorite moves, so it was really good to have one event that I knew I could nail.
Were you trying to get a certain weight up today?
I was trying to PR, and I did, so.
Congratulations. Do you know how much you PR'd by?
I think it was about 6 pounds, so.
Very impressive. Nice showing tonight.
Thank you.
A PR for Pip Malone, and she currently sits in fourth place overall. Amanda Goodman, still your overall leader. Elizabeth Akinwale and Gretchen Killeberger, and the women we expected, sit on top of the leaderboard.
They do, and the women we have next, though, the women we're going to see are the ones that came out of that pool really strong, but the weights might not be for them. There's a lot of numbers that they're going to be chasing.
241 pounds, still the top score, and that belongs to Amanda Goodman. Rory McKernan is on the competition floor. Let's send it down to Rome.
So why did the event organizers choose the overhead squat for this event? Well, the reason is because it has absolutely no peer in expressing multiple athletic opportunities in one place in one time. Obviously, you have to be strong. You also have to be flexible, super well balanced. A regular squat is difficult enough, but it's easy to see how the stakes are raised with weight overhead when the bar goes forward, or if you can't keep your chest up and readily meet the eye is that more than any amount of sit-ups or any kind of abdominal ninjutsu, this movement requires huge midline stability. So if you want abs like a CrossFitter, put some weight overhead.
Thank you, Roe. And the 2014 Reebok CrossFit Games continue this weekend as years of training is put to the test to crown the fittest on earth. Tune in Friday night at 9 on ESPN. Saturday's competition begins at 8. That's also on ESPN. And then on Sunday, the competition concludes as Rich Froning tries to four-peat live at 8 on ESPN2. All events are live on Watch ESPN. Tanya, this final heat We have some women who can put themselves in very good position heading in to the crux of the competition that starts on Friday.
Absolutely. We have Cara Webb, Michelle Tondra, Camila Blanc-Resiné, some of these girls that are strong, and they're going to come out with the confidence from this morning's event. Really anxious to see what they put up right now.
Camila Blanc-Resiné out of Canada East, a shaker cup in her left hand, a coffee cup in her right. Who's who of the women's competition in this final heat in lane two? Julie Fouché. She is back after a one-year absence to go to med school. And in lane seven, there's Cara Webb, who finished third at the beach. And then Camila Blanc-Resiné, a woman who may have a chance to beat Amanda Goodman.
And Camila, she is just so strong, and her numbers keep going up. She did 240 pounds in an overhead squat a couple weeks ago in practice, and typical Camila style, she said, I want 250. So she's, that is her goal tonight, seeing what the leaders already have put up, 241 pounds. I wonder what is going through her head. She wants this bad. I expect to see her go for 242, if not more.
LeBlanc-Resiné finished sixth at the pool, but it's Julie Fouché, the woman who stood on the podium in 2012, looking to do better this year, and that would be winning her first ever CrossFit Games.
Yeah, Julie Fouché is just a well-rounded athlete, is able to put up heavy weights, but max lifts, she's not known for her max lifts, not known for strength like some of the other athletes, but she will do well here, but she needs to do well. She needs to be really smart with the weight that she chooses.
Julie Fouché is up first. She finished 13th at the beach, looking to get a top 10 performance here.
10 seconds.
Julie Fouché up first, 211 pounds on the bar for the woman from Ann Arbor, Michigan.
Fast, not sure she's going to be able to hold on to it, but I think she felt the speed that she needs to go. Slow down just a little bit coming up, able to make that lift.
Lauren Fisher, who is just 20 years old, attempting 220 pounds. This is a woman with a great Olympic lifting background. She could make some noise here.
She's hoping for the Olympics maybe in 2020 Olympics.
220 for Lauren Fisher out of Southern California. She finished third place in that regional competition, making her first appearance as an individual at the CrossFit Games. Danae Brown, 203. She finished first in the pretty competitive Australia region. She will hit 203 pounds. She actually qualified for the games back in 2012, but withdrew because she was pregnant. So this is the first time she's gotten to compete here at the CrossFit Games. Now Kristen Holte finished third in Europe, making her first lift at 190 pounds. And that will count for Holte, 190 pounds. Cassidy Lance, the biggest opening lift we've seen so far early on in this third and final heat. 225 pounds for Cassidy. And that will count. Cassidy Lance opening up strong at 225.
Very strong and great flexibility. You can just see the body position doesn't change much from the start of the squat to the end.
Cara Webb is going to try to beat that by 10 pounds. Webb, 235 pounds. If she hits this, she could chase down Amanda Goodman, and that was no problem.
That was a warm-up lift, for sure.
235 for Cara Webb. Remember, Cara Webb, a strong performance this morning. She finished third at the beach. If she keeps this up, she could be on top of the leaderboard after day one. And now the woman who won the opening event, Anna Tunnicliffe. 190 pounds for Tunnicliffe on her opening lift. China Cho sits in second place after the first event. 195 pounds for her. Nice and smooth, and that will count.
Again, good body position. She has great flexibility, really good squat. Which just saves the good efficiency, just saves the energy.
Michelle Letondra, fourth place at the beach this morning, going after 205 pounds on her first of three lifts. No problem for Michelle Letendre at 205. Now Camille LeBlanc-Bazinet, 225 pounds on her opening lift.
From the front rack, it's very impressive to see these girls go from the front rack to the jerk.
And good for Camille LeBlanc-Bazinet, who looked like she was struggling with that thing overhead. Wasn't very solid, but then got into a spot that she liked.
And she just said it's the first one. Just get the nerves out, but when you see that shaky overhead, a lot goes through your head.
Valerie Vogrel, 185 pounds on the bar for the woman who is a fourth grade school teacher. And that will count. Valerie Vogrel opening up at 185, making her fourth appearance here at the CrossFit Games.
She locked that down real nice. Not a wiggle in that bar.
Amanda Schwartz, her opening lift, 190 pounds. This is her first appearance at the CrossFit Games. And that is a good lift. Amanda Schwartz on the board at 190 pounds. We're closing out this first of three rounds here in the final heat. Bjork Odensdotter out of the Europe region. Another rookie here who did extremely well this morning at the beach. 210, and that was smooth for Bjork Odensdotter. Final lift of this final heat in the first round. Two more lifts for all these women. Emily Bridgers going after 205 pounds. No question there for Emily Bridgers as she closes out the first round with a lift of 205 pounds and back to Julie Fouché, who has added 10 pounds on her bar and now looks at 221.
And unlike Thorsdottir, who took last year off due to an injury, Julie Fouché took last year off to train, but to be a medical student and to focus on her school. But she was training that year. It was a year of recovery, of rest in some ways from competition. So she's coming back not with any negative thoughts in her head or not with any question mark about what body part is broken, which is a good thing for her.
235 pounds is the leading score so far in this heat. That belongs to Cara Webb. The leader at the top of your screen will be listed in blue. And a good lift at 221 for Julie Fouché.
She controlled that speed a little better now. And this lift looked real strong there.
Now Lauren Fisher, 231 pounds for her.
Again, just incredible strength. Come up that front rack.
Fisher struggled a little, but that one is going to count. Lauren Fisher with a good lift on her second attempt at 231. Janae Brown at 211 pounds. And Danae Brown, a second good lift, moving up to 211 pounds.
And for Danae Brown, the three-rep overhead squat in the 2013 regional knocked her out with an injury. So this is just getting a little revenge here at the big stage at the Games.
Kristen Holte did not get deep enough and then ditched the weight. So she will be stuck at 190 pounds after two lifts. Now it's Cassidy Lance trying to inch closer to Cara Webb. 232 pounds on the bar for Cassidy Lance. The best lift we've seen all day so far still belongs to Amanda Goodman at 241. Good lift for Cassidy Lance, 232 pounds. And now Cara Webb, your leader here in this third and final heat, looking to be your leader overall with 245 pounds on the bar for the Australian.
Just a little balance check.
And Cara Webb is your new leader at 245 pounds.
Nice lift, very strong.
Anna Tunnicliffe hit 190, now looking at 198 pounds. She got it, but just barely.
Yeah, you can see the focus. The bar starts to turn. She took her body with it, which was smart not to lose it.
China Cho was good at 195. Trying to up that total to 210. That looked just
real
as good as the
nice
first one.
Such a nice squat. Very good mover to watch. Such control.
Michelle Letendre, 220 pounds on the bar for the woman who's making her fourth appearance at the CrossFit Games. And that is good. So LaTondra ups her total to 220. Now Camille LeBlanc-Bazinet, 235 pounds, trying to leapfrog Cassie Lance and Lauren Fisher and move into second place in this heat. And that is good for Camille LeBlanc-Bazinet, who now sits in second place in this heat.
And it almost looks as if Camille has a stronger squat than she does overhead position. It just, the bar just shakes, so it's good that she's able to quickly get into that squat.
Valerie Boveril, 197 pounds. Can't get out of the hole on that one, but 185 still on the board for Val Boveril, and she still has one lift to go. On to Amanda Schwartz. Upping her first lift by 10 pounds. And that is good for Amanda Schwartz. She sits at 200 pounds with one lift to go in this final heat.
And I stand corrected, it was Schwartz in 2013 that was knocked out by the 126 overhead through at max. So very impressive there for her.
Bjork Odin's daughter hit 210, now going for 222. And she will get it, the rookie looking strong here in event number two, the one rep max overhead squat.
That bar started to come forward. I didn't think she was going to be able to pull that out.
Final lift of this second round, Emily Bridgers hit 205, now going for 215. And that will count for Emily Bridgers, 215 pounds, but after two rounds, it's Cara Webb with the overall lead at 245 pounds. And now Julie Fouché looking to tie Lauren Fisher for fourth place in this heat at 231 pounds. We'll get it.
She ran out of room there with that rack, but great composure. Very strong on the way down.
Lauren Fisher at 238. No problem. This woman is 20 years old and 135 pounds.
Beautiful squat. Coach CJ Martin is just thrilled. Very happy for her.
That currently puts Lauren Fisher in fourth place overall. Here's Danae Brown at 222. And no problem for Danae Brown as she closes out day number one. 222 will be her final score here in the second event. Now Kristen Holte hit 190, looking at 206. Didn't get deep enough. She got no rep right off the bat, but she makes another attempt. She does have time to make another attempt. And that one will count.
Good for her.
So a double for Kristen Holte.
At a max effort, that was very impressive.
Cassidy Lance trying to tie Amanda Goodman for second place right now overall in this event. And Lance does get it. 241 for Cassidy Lance.
Very impressive to hold on to that. She came up and wanted it so bad and held on.
Cara Webb says, why not? I'll go for 250 pounds.
Oh!
They'll count it, 250 for Cara Webb as she's looking to win event number two and possibly sit atop the leaderboard after day one here at the 2014 Reebok CrossFit Games.
What a first day for her.
Anna Tunnicliffe can't get 206, but 198, a solid score for Anna Tunnicliffe.
Absolutely, I'm very impressed with that. The bar just started to press her down too much. She couldn't fight against it.
China Cho, who finished second at the beach this morning, closes out at 222.
Very nice look for China.
Michelle LaTondra, 231 on the bar for her final attempt.
The official time, Julie Fouché.
And that is good for Michelle LaTondra. She finishes with 231 pounds as her score. Camille LeBlanc-Bazinet trying to lock up second place overall in this event, and that would put her in the top three after day one. And she will get it. She beats Amanda Goodman by 1 pound.
Very impressive. She's excited about it. Wasn't 250, but she is thrilled with 242.
Valerie Vogel making another attempt at 200 pounds, her third and final lift, and she just has not had that one in the bag. But Valerie Vogel doing what she does and just hanging out. Good position heading into the weekend. Amanda Schwartz, her final lift at 207 pounds. And Schwartz just can't hold that one overhead, so she will finish with a score of 200. Bjork Odensdotter, the 26-year-old out of Stockholm, Sweden, her rookie appearance here at the CrossFit Games, closing out with an attempt at 231 pounds. And that will count for Bjork Odensdotter, 231. Final lift for the women belongs to Emily Bridgers. She hit 215, now looking at 222 pounds. And Bridgers getting out of it and making the lift.
Great job getting out of the bottom. That was a little extra pause there, and that is hard to get out there, but she did it.
So the ladies certainly do not disappoint, and Cara Webb definitely didn't disappoint. She will sit in first place overall after two events as she wins the overhead squat one rep max, 250 pounds for Cara Webb.
So impressive, ridiculously strong, and I'll tell you, I am just so thoroughly impressed that these ladies that did so well earlier today in that swim event were able to turn around in something completely opposite and show us their strength with the most difficult movement, in my opinion, for weights for a one rep max, and that's the overhead squat. Very impressive, especially for Cara Webb.
Cassidy Lance ties for third at 241.
And real strong out of the bottom. She was able to hold on at the top. Even when the bar took her to the side, was able to fight and hold on to it.
And then Amanda Goodman, who put one more pound on the bar than Elizabeth Akinwale, and made 241 look pretty light.
Looked like a breeze. Wonder now how she did in the later heat, what she would put on the bar, seeing what those other women could do. And Camille LeBlanc-Bazinet got 240 earlier a few weeks ago. Super happy. This is a PR for her and sets her well atop the leaderboard in what she's used to seeing this early on in the games. But Cara Webb, first place overall in this event at 250, just stable, strong in the shoulders and in her core.
Cara Webb, a third place this morning at the beach, a first place in event number two, and she is standing by with Amanda Krenz.
Cara, did you have a number in mind when you came out on the floor tonight?
I did. I've always got plan A and plan B. It just depended on, you know, the ball was left in my court as to what I could lift out in the tunnel, and then I could make the decision from there on what was sort of a safe bet. But I had sort of plan A and plan B. I went with plan B, which was the stronger option. So it was like, if it's feeling good, then strike, go for it. If I can use a crowd, and if I'm feeling good, then definitely take advantage of it. And I did that, and it worked really well.
What do you think about how day one went for you today?
I am just incredibly grateful to be here, full stop. And this is my third year at the Games, and I think only now I'm really taking the time to just appreciate the fact that I'm lucky enough to be here, I'm healthy enough to be here, and have the opportunity to compete. And day one was a great start. There's still a lot of work to go, but I'm feeling really happy and loving CrossFit.
Thanks, Cara. Good job.
Thank you.
Cara Webb out of Australia wins event number two with a final lift of 250 pounds. Camille LeBlanc-Bazinet, she had a great day one, 242 pounds. And Amanda Goodman and Cassidy Lance tie for third. Your overall standings through two events. It's Cara Webb at 190 points. Camila Blanc-Bazinet sits in second, and Cassidy Lance sits in third place, followed by Michelle Atondra and China Cho, rounding out the top five. The big weights went up for the women. Amanda Goodman had the early lead. She battled Elizabeth Akinwale. Annie Thoreau's daughter made her run. But it was Cara Webb who managed to jump over Amanda Goodman and take the win. The men are coming up next. We'll have it for you when we return to the tennis stadium at the StubHub Center in Carson, California. Hello, everybody, and welcome inside the tennis stadium at the StubHub Center in Carson, California, for the second event of the 2014 Reebok CrossFit Games for the men. It's the One Rep Max Overhead Squat. I'm Sean Woodland alongside Bill Grundler. And Bill, this morning, these guys had to go to the beach. They went through this long, grueling event. Now it's just simple. Lift big.
It's going to be a straight old school bro session with these guys throwing down some big weights. Let's get classic here, Sean. That's what we're going to do.
Richard Bolkin will go in this first heat. A lot of the men in this opening heat did not do well at the beach, and that means they have a ton of ground to make up. This event is pretty simple. One rep max overhead squat.
Put it up over your head, see what you can do. We have three attempts to see what your max overall is going to be. If you set a certain weight, you can't go below that, so you got to make sure you stay there. But we're going to see some big weights thrown out, especially in this heat.
The starting list for the first of three heats for the men. Albert Dominique LaRouche has been a consistent performer. You talked about big weight. Keep an eye on lane number nine. That's where Neil Maddox will be working. Richard Bolkin is up first, making his first appearance here at the CrossFit Games, starting at 275 pounds.
Nice and easy. What you're going to see these athletes doing is just getting that bar up overhead however they want to do it, whether they're going to do a split jerk or just a straight press jerk overhead. Lock it out, secure that core, tighten down that midline, lock out their shoulders, and go all the way down to that deep squat. Make sure that hip crease goes down below the waist, and then come back up in control. And that's what the judges are going to be looking for.
Manuel Maldonado out of the Latin America region, starting off at 295 pounds. That's not going to happen for Maldonado, but he will have two more lifts in this first heat. Cody Anderson, another rookie. He's out of the Northwest, 315 pounds.
And not one of the bigger athletes. Only weighs about 165 pounds. And able to get 315 and made it look really easy. That was a great lift for him.
Albert Dominique LaRouche, the police officer from Chambly, Quebec, Canada. First in Canada East. His fourth appearance here at the CrossFit Games. He's also going for 315 pounds.
Trying to check himself there. You can see the bobble. That's that core stability, trying to support that weight. Was able to come back up and go for that a second attempt. That was impressive. It takes a lot of extra energy just to take a shot, come back up, and then go for it again. That's tough.
285 on the bar for Rob Forte, who won the Australia region. This is his fourth trip to the CrossFit Games and hits that pretty easily. Tyson Takasaki going big here right off the bat. 335 pounds on the bar.
That was easy.
That was like a warm-up weight.
Now, you know, these guys all were warming up in the back, making sure that they could make their way up this weight. You don't want to come out and hit 335 cold like that, but wow, that was easy.
Eric Carmody out of the Asia region. He's a CrossFit Games rookie. This guy once weighed 270 pounds, five less than what was on the bar that he just hit.
That was impressive. Again, looks super easy, but this right here, Neil Maddox, this is what I've been waiting to see. He actually said 400 pounds is going up. So he's starting with 335 here, but I expect to see something big from him, especially after not doing what he wanted to do in the swing.
This will tie Tyson Takasaki for the lead. And that was easy for him.
Okay, time to make a big jump on the next one.
Neil Maddox, the oldest man in the competition, at 36 years old, and now another CrossFit Games veteran, Patrick Burke. This is his sixth appearance here at the CrossFit Games. Burke hits 285 pounds on his opening lift.
Looks easy. That was great. Lucas Parker, another strong athlete when it comes to barbell movements.
345, and this will put Lucas in first place all by himself. Parker can't hold it overhead. You can't decrease the weight. Cannot go down in weight. So Lucas Parker will have to make another attempt at least 345 pounds. Here's Marcus Philly out of Northern California. Finished 33rd at the games last year.
Not a problem there at all. That. And you can see if there's a slight wiggle with these athletes, that's when they're going to lose that bar. I mean, it takes literally a quarter of an inch to move out of place, and that weight's going to come down.
Paul Tremblay finished 39th this morning at the beach, and he's a guy who needs to make some noise here in event number two to climb back up the leaderboard. 335, that'll count.
That'll do it.
Alex Nettie, his second appearance here at the games. He's out of the North Central region. 296 pounds on the bar for Alex. Good lift for Alex
Nettie. That looked great.
Jeff Evans, one of the more powerful athletes in the men's field. He's going for 345. This would put him in the lead. Lucas Parker tried this a couple lifts ago. Couldn't make it happen.
And he was the last person in the water this morning, so he needs to go big. He knew he wasn't going to do well in the swim. We know he's strong. Now it's just how strong is he going to be?
And Jeff Evans is in first place after one round. 345 for the former wide receiver at Southern Illinois University. Leader will be listed in blue at the top as we start the second of three rounds here in the opening heat of event number two with the 2014 Reebok CrossFit Games. Richard Folkin hit 275, now going for 290. And he will get it, 290 pounds now for Richard Folkin.
If these athletes can find that groove, there's that sweet spot when you're carrying that weight up overhead. Let those shoulders lock in and just support that weight. Crank down on that midsection. That belt helps too.
Emmanuel Maldonado missed his first attempt for 295. And he can't get that one, so Maldonado now two failed lifts.
He really needs to fight for that a little bit more. He's got to realize that he only has three shots at this. You have to fight for it all the way.
Cody Anderson, who weighs 160 pounds, 325,
wow.
Looking easy.
Now, this is not the event that you would expect to have the smaller, lighter athletes doing so well, but he is, wow, he is totally changing it all up for me right here. I'm all confused.
Albert Dominic LaRouche hit 315, now going for 330 on his second attempt. Can't quite get out of the hole there. But still one good lift on the board for Albert Dominic LaRouche at 315. Rob Forte moves up to 300.
There it goes.
Rob
nice
Forte
job.
Hits
nice
300.
Job.
Tyson Takasaki, 356 pounds to leapfrog Jeff Evans for first place overall.
So relaxed. Look at that. He was so smooth going down.
Takasaki crushes that weight.
That, again, so easy. He was so solid going down and coming back up. Not a bobble. Oh, wow. That was powerful. That was power right there.
356 is your new top score here in the opening heat. Now Eric Carmody out of the Asia region hit 275, going for 295. Carmody will hit that. He moves up to 295 pounds. Neil Maddox, 365 after Tyson Takasaki just hit 356. Neil Maddox is your new leader at 365 pounds.
So that was a 30-pound jump for him. He'd have to do a 35-pound jump to get 400 in that. Ooh, that's going to be dicey. Dicey.
Patrick Burke at 300 pounds. And that will count. So Patrick Burke increases his total by 15.
All right, Lucas, he's got to get on the board this time.
350 for Lucas. Parker has yet to hit a successful lift. Missed his first one.
Oh, oh, oh.
350 for Lucas Parker.
Now that was fight through that. That's all that was. You can see he was starting to get out of position. Shoulder was starting to internally rotate a little bit, but he fought through it the whole way and held it. That was great.
Marcus Philly. He goes for 325 pounds. So this first heat, certainly not disappointing. Now Paul Trombley, he hit 335 in his first attempt. Now at 355.
Nice little easy jerk there, no big deal. Jeez.
Ooh. Ditches that behind him. He was really wide there.
He was. He really was. But he's got, you know, he's got long arms. He's not a short athlete by any means. So you're going to see some of these athletes going as wide as they can.
316 on the bar now for Alex Nettie. And that is a good lift for the man from Chicago, Illinois. 316 pounds now on the board. And here comes Jeff Evans trying to tie Neil Maddox for the best lift of the day so far for the men. Evans will get it, and now we have a battle between Jeff Evans and that man, Neil Maddox, both former football players, and then the other guy, Tyson Takasagi, he's another football player. Somewhat of a coincidence, I doubt.
I'm going to think that they probably thrown some weights around in their time. But look at him. Neil knows exactly what's happening. He's like, okay, I see you over there. I see you. I'm going to add an extra pound or two.
Tyson Takasagi currently sits in third, and now it's the third and final round of the opening heat here. Richard Bolkin trying to close out at 307. And can't hold it overhead, but still 290. A very good score for the rookie. Emmanuel Maldonado has to hit this one. Missed his first two attempts at 295. This is his last chance. And Emmanuel Maldonado stays alive. The third try is the charm for the man from Latin America.
Wow, I'm just blown away by Cody and his strength right now. I'm literally floored.
21 years old, and he can't make that one happen, but he weighs just 160 pounds.
Impressive.
325 will be his final score. Albert Dominic LaRouche with an attempt at 330 pounds. For Albert Dominic LaRouche, 330 will be his final score. Rob Forte trying to close out at 316 pounds. And that's a good lift for Rob Forte.
Whoa.
And Tyson Takasagi's not messing around, and he will not get that lift, but he will close out at 356. So Neil Maddox and Jeff Evans are now left to battle it out for the top spot in this heat. Eric Carmody trying to go above 300 pounds, 315 on the bar for Carmody, the representative out of the Asia region. Great lift for Eric Carmody, 315. As he closes out event number two. Now Neil Maddox, 380 on the bar as Jeff Evans looks on.
He just gets that weight up so easy. He's so strong in his.
Whoa! And can't hold it, so the door is open for Jeff Evans.
Was not expecting that, and you knew. You could look at Neil. He knows exactly what happened right there. This was not the event that he needed to lose at all.
He's still in solid position here if Jeff Evans cannot hit his third and final lift, but right now Patrick Burke at 317. Burke can't stand that one up. We'll finish with a score of 300. Don't forget about this guy. Lucas Parker won't be good for the lead, but it would put him in second place. 360 on the bar for the beard from Canada West.
He really holds the weight a long time. I know he's trying to make sure that it's nice and stable, but that's a lot of extra energy that's wasted. And then again, when you descend that slow, that's just wasted energy also. So you want to find that right tempo down and up.
Marcus Philly going after 338 on his final attempt.
Nice.
And that will count. So Marcus Philly closing out with a 338-pound overhead squat. Paul Tremblay, he's trying to tie Jeff Evans and Neil Maddox at 365, making a 30-pound jump from his last lift. And Paul Tremblay is fired up as he is now tied for first place with Neil Maddox and Jeff Evans at 365 pounds. Alex Nenny is up next, and then Jeff Evans with his final lift. Hit 326, and Jeff Evans for the overall lead at 375 pounds.
You can see he's starting to just waver just a touch.
That will count.
Wow.
375 for Jeff Evans, are you not entertained?
I'm just blown away. That's just pure, raw power. It's not the cleanest. It's not the prettiest. It's not the most correct. But wow, it is all the way down. It's all the way up. He just moves that weight like nobody's did. That was impressive. But that's exactly what we were expecting to see and wanted to see from him, especially after this morning.
Jeff Evans had a terrible showing in the opening event, and he more than makes up for it here. If that score holds, he will win event number two, and that will put him back in the thick of things here at the 2014 Reebok CrossFit Games. 375 pounds. He beats out Neil Maddox by 10 pounds, and Paul Tremblay as well. This wasn't expected from Paul Tremblay.
Not at all, but just so smooth on the way down. Did you see how solid and compact he was? There wasn't any wavering at all on that lift. Beautiful lift, so much power.
The Neil Maddox at 365, his last successful lift, put him in second place. But it was all about this guy.
So much power. I just couldn't believe how solid this looked. I mean, look at that. The fact that he's having to move around to regain control and then goes and puts on it. Just amazing, amazing.
Jeff Evans is fired up and right now standing by with Amanda Krenz.
What do you think about that?
My stomach is tight as I could just to catch it back up once I start leaning to the left, coming back up with it.
So you're a rookie here. Were you playing it safe?
I definitely want my name known. I'm here to work. Definitely.
Well, you showed that tonight. Nice job.
Thank you.
Jeff Evans will now sit and watch, but that is going to be a tough lift to beat. 375 pounds over Neil Maddox and Paul Tremblay, who both turn in lifts of 365. Boy, did Jeff Evans need that performance.
That was exactly what he needed, and it was a beautiful lift. And I really didn't think that we were going to see many people lift more in the later heats than this heat. So we're just going to see if those scores stand.
Two former men's champions are competing here. One of them is coaching. Rory McKernan is on the competition floor.
The 2009 CrossFit Games started with a very similar pairing of movements. It went 7-kilometer run, then deadlift. the man who went second, then first, went on to win. That's the 09 champ, Mikko Salo, here with me now. He coaches Jaana Koski. So, Mikko, Jaana was second on the beach. How is he going to back that up here tonight on the overhead squat?
Probably not going to win the event, but he's going to do a solid performance here. He's a good overall crossfitter, so he's going to do a solid.
So it's been a couple years since you've been back. What surprises you when you watch these events?
So the whole event is so huge at the moment. The athletes are getting all the time better, so it's amazing. It's amazing.
Are you coming back, Mikko?
Probably.
Thank you.
Thanks.
We would love to see Mikko Salo back in competition, but right now we're going to have to watch the 2008 CrossFit Games champion, Jason Khalipa, and the rest of the second of three heats here. Tommy Hackenbrook in lane number three, another powerful athlete, as is Jason Khalipa in lane number seven. Hackenbrook, who's been on the winning CrossFit Games team the past 2 years, now going individual. And then Nate Schrader in lane 15. He's another big, powerful athlete.
He is, absolutely, but this is not his strong event, so we're going to see how he can hang in here. But I'm so anxious. I've been waiting to see what Tommy can do going solo. He's so strong, so powerful, so I want to see what he can do. I want to see some big weights being thrown around by him.
Jason Khalipa is a guy who worked a lot on his weaknesses and did pretty well for someone who doesn't like longer events at the beach, making his seventh consecutive CrossFit Games appearance, just one of three athletes to appear in seven CrossFit Games. Only one other man has done that, and that is Chris Spieler. Matt Fraser, the rookie from the Northeast region, and this is a guy that likes putting weight over his head.
When they had the overhead squat last year in the regionals, he was the one that in the worldwide, if you were to rank everybody, he won this event at 315 pounds for two reps. 315 pounds for two reps, more than anybody. So I'm expecting to see something giant from him today.
If someone has a chance of possibly tracking down Jeff Evans at 375, it could be that man, Matt Fraser, the rookie. Jeff Germond will start heat number two.
Lift.
Jeff Germond, a rookie. He's out of the South Central region, where he finished second at that competition, opening up at 295 pounds. Good opening lift, Germond.
And again, the first lift is so important. They want to have that confidence going into the rest of them. They don't want to feel like they're chasing anybody.
Tommy Hackenbrook, 356 for his opening lift.
Oh, hi, how you doing? I'm just going to go crazy here. On lift number one.
Oh, and that was easy.
Gosh.
Look out, Jeff Evans. 356 for Tommy Hackenbrook. Kyle Kasperbauer up next is Matt Fraser waiting his turn. James Hobart at his bar as well. Another rookie. Kasperbauer, the man who won the North Central region. 315, no problem for Kyle. James Hobart, who's been a member of the CrossFit New England team, appeared at the games going individual. The guy trains with Rich Froning sometimes, and he hits 295.
What's amazing with him, no real athletic background at all. Just kind of got into the CrossFit thing, and he's just been killing it since he got in.
This is Bjorkman Carl Gudmundsson out of Europe. He starts at 296. Good lift for Gudmundsson. 296 on the board for him. Now, Jason Khalipa opening up at 337 pounds. Khalipa hitting that and opening strong.
It's a strong first lift. I mean, there's a lot of jitters coming out on that first lift, so that's a nice way. I mean, the fact that he's that heavy starting out of the gates, that's beautiful.
Jacob Hefner out of the North Central region making his first appearance at the CrossFit Games. He starts at 280 pounds. That was smooth.
That was easy.
280 for Jacob Hefner. Here's the rookie, Matt Fraser, 366.
We're going to attempt to start off winning. How about that? Oh, my
God. Got stuck, but gets it overhead. And now wow. Jeff Evans has some serious competition. Matt Fraser, 366.
The fact that he stopped halfway on the way back up and was able to keep going, that was impressive.
Jordan Cook will hit 300 pounds. Going with the snatch balance. Lucas Hoberg, another European athlete. He finished second in that region. His first appearance here at the CrossFit Games. He starts with 286 pounds. No rep, didn't get low enough. He can make another run at this thing, though, but chooses to drop the bar. On to Ben Stoneberg. Finished 16th last year at the CrossFit Games. His third appearance. He opens at 335.
And over the past year, since the last CrossFit Games, he's just been getting stronger and stronger and stronger. I've seen some great back squats. Whoa! Oh, and I thought he was going to actually pull that one out.
It looks like the judge may have counted that one. I saw him give him a yes motion, and he is changing the scorecard, so the judge counting that. Ben Stoneberg is on the board. Travis Mayer opens at 295.
With another snatch balance. Wow, back to his back. Travis is doing a little more work than he needs to on that one.
Quinton Z. Van Rooyen. He is the first man from the Africa region, not from South Africa. He is a native of Namibia, and he is proud to be representing his continent and his country here at the CrossFit Games, and he opens at 275 pounds. Can't get out of the hole there, but he does have two more attempts. And now finally, to close out the first round, Nate Schrader opening up at 316 pounds.
I was talking to him earlier today, and he was saying, I really wish this would have been a one rep max deadlift instead of an overhead. Of all the squats, this is his worst one. So he's just hoping he's able to get a decent enough score to kind of keep him in the mix.
And that will count for Nate Schrader. He closes out the first round with a lift of 316 pounds, and we begin round two. The score to beat still belongs to Jeff Evans at 375 pounds, but there are a couple guys in this heat who could possibly pass that on this lift. Jeff Jermond, his second attempt, going for 310 pounds. Jermond cannot make it out of the hole there. And now for the lead, Tommy Hackenbrook, another former football player, 376. This would beat Evans by 1 pound. And we have a new leader, Tommy Hackenbrook, with one more lift to go, 376.
He's been the only athlete to verbally say out loud, Rich, I'm coming for you. You better be eating your Wheaties. Guess what? We're not swimming right now. We're lifting, but guess what, Rich?
Someone might be on his heels after two events. Kyle Kasperbauer, 330. And that is good for Kyle Kasperbauer, a man who once stood on the podium here at the CrossFit Games. He finished third in 2012. .305 counts for James Hobart, his second attempt. Jorgen Carl Gudmundsson made his first lift, now going after 316 pounds as Jason Kaliba looks on. .316 in the bag for Jorgen Carl Gudmundsson. Jason Kalipa, 352, currently sits in third place. And that will count in this heat. Kalipa at 352 pounds with one more lift to go. Jacob Hefner, 280 on his first lift, now at 300 pounds.
Looks good. surprised he's sitting down so low. I mean, he's moving that weight so easily.
Now Matt Fraser, 377, trying to beat Tommy Hackenbrook. And Fraser will do it. He is your new leader by a pound.
We're going to have a serious chess match going on here in a second, Sean. Because what's Matt going to do? Because Matt Fraser gets hit and watched. So, what's going to happen?
Fraser and Hackenbrook exchanging a smile right there. Jordan Cook will hit 315. Good lift for the rookie out of the South Central region. Lucas Hoberg missed his first attempt. Second attempt now at 286 pounds. And that will count, so Lucas Hoberg gets himself on the board with his second lift. Ben Stoneberg. Another attempt at 335. Good lift for Ben Stoneberg, so 335 pounds. Don't know if the loading of the scorecard was wrong on that because he did the exact same lift that he did in the first round. Now Travis Mayer at 310. Good lift for Mayer. Quinton Z. Van Royen out of Africa is up next. He missed his first attempt. 275 pounds on the bar for Quinton. You want to talk about a rookie? This guy started CrossFit in January of this year.
Hey, guess what? There's this thing called the Open coming up. You might want to check it out in March.
So no good for Quinton Z. Van Royen. So one attempt left for him. Nate Schrader loads the bar with 331 pounds.
Yeah, he's fighting the bobble on that one. Wow.
But he will hit it, so 331 for Nate Schrader.
Nice job on that.
Third and final round, Jeff Tremont at 316. Tommy Hackenbrook is up next, and then Matt Fraser will lift after Hackenbrook. So Fraser will get to see what Hackenbrook does. But first, Jeff Tremont at 316 pounds. And Jermon makes it count, so he'll close out with a score of 316 pounds.
All right, so this is the number we've been looking for, waiting for. It's someone going to hit 400.
400 pounds for Tommy Hackenbrook. This would be the best lift we've seen all day, and he can't get it overhead. So Matt Fraser is your leader. He doesn't need to add anything else, and you saw him pick up the weight the size of a nickel and put it on there because he doesn't have to do much more. Because Hackenbrook rolled the dice, went for 400, it didn't count, but he's still in second place overall right now. Kyle Kasperbauer at 350. And a good lift for Kyle Kasperbauer, closing out at 350 pounds.
Nice to see Kyle back in action here. He was a little rough last year at the games. But he's looking not too shabby so far.
James Hobart, former team's competitor. With CrossFit New England, 317 is good for him.
It looks like he's happy to be done with this one, too.
Yeah, day one is now in the books for James Hobart. Bjorgvin Carl Goodmanson at 335. Can't hit that one, but he is okay because Goodmanson had a good lift at 316. Here's Jason Kalipa, 367. This would move him into third place in this heat. And Kalipa will hit it. Not the prettiest thing, but he makes it work.
He's not easy, but that's Jason Kalipa right there. Doesn't have to be the prettiest. It just has to get work has to be done, and he does it.
Jacob Heppner hit 300, closing out with 311. Didn't get deep enough. He's going to make another attempt.
Wow.
How about that? Wow. Oh, he cannot stand it up. But 300 pounds, a solid score for Jacob Heppner. Now Matt Fraser just showing off, and it didn't work out for him, but he's still your leader by 1 pound over that man, Tommy Hackenbrook, who hit 376, and Matt Fraser looking over at Hackenbrook, and the two of them sharing a little bit of a chuckle. Jordan Cook, his final lift at 330. Cook will hit that, so 330 pounds for Jordan Cook. And he is fired up because he needed a solid performance here in event two. Lucas Hoberg, final lift, 317 pounds. And he will hit that, so Hoberg closes it out with 317. Ben Stoneberg goes to 368. Not going to happen. Just couldn't
get it back there. Couldn't get back in the sockets right. Those shoulders are just out of position.
Travis Mayer hit 310 in his final lift. Mayer looking at 335 pounds here. That just when you could tell right off the bat that wasn't going to happen for him. Now it's Quinton Z. Van Rooy. Failed his first two attempts. Needs to hit this lift. He's fighting for it, and Quinton Z. Van Rooy on his final attempt at 275, and that draws applause from Tommy Hackenbrook, the man who currently sits in second place overall in this event. Nate Schrader to close out the second of three heats at 340.
I can see his hips are starting to fade to the one side. Just couldn't get solid underneath that bar at all.
331 will be the final score for Nate Schrader, but it's Matt Fraser who will leave the floor as your new overall leader. 377 pounds. He beats Tommy Hackenbrook by 1 pound, Jeff Evans by two. Jason Kalipa.
The California Bear does what he does best. It doesn't look pretty, but he just gets work done. He is a hard, hard worker, and that was a great lift by him in the end.
Well, Kalipa in solid position after day one, and now Tommy Hackenbrook, who went big right off the bat.
And I love this. I love the fact that he's pushing the envelope here. Went big here, tried the 400, but wow, that was a good, strong, solid lift by Tommy.
Then finally, it was Matt Fraser, the rookie, 1 pound better.
Just so solid. But you know what? I knew he was going to come in strong. I think everyone else knew he was going to come in strong, so that was impressive.
Matt Fraser will sit and watch one last heat. He stands by live with Amanda Krenz.
Matt, why didn't you just go for 400 there on your last lift?
I hit 385 in training, and there wasn't really a need to go for 400. I figured I'd just didn't play it safe, but got a little off balance.
You and Tommy have a friendly rivalry there?
Oh, yeah, of course. Yeah.
Kind of do this around the world thing and get to watch how much weight they were lifting. Did that affect how much you put on your bar?
Oh, absolutely. I mean, I would have never put on 377. It added a different element having the fractional plates, everyone.
Apologize for the technical difficulties, but it is Matt Fraser who is now your new leader at 377 pounds. Tommy Hackenbrook will sit in second place overall, and Jeff Evans, who hit 375 in the first heat, will be in third. Jason Kalipa putting himself in really good position after two events as we head into the weekend. Let's send it down to Rory McKernan on the competition floor.
The composition of this event is beautiful by Dave Castro in the way that it promotes gamesmanship. You saw the battle between Matt and Tommy Hackenbrook going back and forth by 1 pound. Well, the fourth from final lifter in this final heat is Mr. Rich Froning, and you guys know that if Rich had 99 problems, a squat would not be one of them.
the three-time defending champion, has few weaknesses. One of them was swimming, but then he came out and finished eighth at the beach. Will Morad taking the floor, but Rich Froning, he finishes eighth in that event.
He classically starts in a hole in the CrossFit game, and most people are used to that as he kind of slowly makes his way up to the top of the leaderboard at the end of the weekend. He's starting off in eighth place right now. That's not where the field wants him to be.
In lane eight is the man who won the opening event for the second straight year. That's Jordan Troyon. If he can come up with a decent performance here, he sets himself up very nicely heading into the events on the weekend.
Have you seen the numbers that are up there yet, Sean?
It's going to be tough.
He's got his work cut out for him.
In lane 12, Rich Froning, who with a solid performance here, if he can approach those numbers, could find himself on top of the leaderboard heading in to Friday. Ben Smith is another athlete in this heat. Smith, I think he's like 12 years old, and he's already been in the games multiple times, but this is a guy who can put up big weight too.
When he gets his hands on a bar, he is so strong. One little hitch with him right now. We know that he rolled his ankle, had a little ankle injury about 3 weeks ago, so we're going to see if this is going to affect him in the bottom of that squat. But most of the time, Ben in a bar, that goes well together like peanut butter and jelly.
The three-time champion, Rich Froning, taking the floor, sits in eighth place overall after one event. If he can get close to Matt Fraser and Tommy Hackenbrook, Jeff Evans and Jason Kalipa, he could be in first place heading into the weekend. He has said that this is his last year competing as an individual. He said it doesn't have to end with a win, but it needs to end with a win. Cole Sanger, the rookie out of the Northwest. This kid is powerful, a former football player at the University of Washington, finds himself here in the final heat.
I wasn't expecting him to do so well in the swimming. We know he's strong in the lifting. I mean, again, you said it. Look at all the football players and what they've done so far today. This is going to be a good one for him. This is definitely going to be a good one for him.
Cole Sager did very well in the swim because his training partner, Rory Zambird, a former swimmer, Chris Spieler, will open up at 255 pounds. The seven-time CrossFit Games competitor on his first lift here at 255. Wheeler's on the board at 255. Will Morad, 305. Morad, while Chris Wheeler is the veteran, Morad, the rookie, his first appearance here at the CrossFit Games.
Will Morad wants to do some overhead squat, pause overhead squats. Went down there and just hung out, make sure he gets it.
And now Ben Smith, the 23-year-old out of Virginia, making his sixth appearance at the CrossFit Games. The tape on his left ankle, Bill talked about that, 345 pounds, and that's good for Ben Smith.
Solid. Wow.
Dan Bailey up next, making his fourth appearance at the CrossFit Games, has never finished lower than eighth.
He's such a mainstay. I mean, it's like CrossFit Games top 10. Oh, Dan Bailey. He's in there.
Also has a very popular alter ego in the CrossFit world, Danny Broflex. In fact, people come up to him and they ask for Danny Broflex's autograph, not Dan Bailey's. Here's Brandon Swan attempting 320 pounds, a man out of Australia. No problem for Brandon Swan. Now another rookie, Noah Olson from the Southeast, 315 pounds on his mark.
Wow, another snatch bounce into the bottom. Solid though, jeez. I would not expect that to be the best movement. There's no way that I could get the same amount of weight that way. It's not as in control.
Josh Bridges at 305. Bridges hitting that. That is big for him because these one-rep events are not in his wheelhouse. He finished third this morning at the beach. If he can finish middle of the pack, that's a great result for him.
That would be perfect for him.
Now Jordan Troyon, 285 pounds, cannot hit that. So here we see the contrast, a guy that's great at the long swimming event, now having problems with the one-rep mats. Janikoski, 19 years old, out of Pori, Finland, and coached by 2009 CrossFit Games champion Mikko Salo.
Solid. Solid lift.
Opens with 296, and that is on the board. Todd Porter finished third at the Australia region. Another rookie in this final heat. And that will count for Todd Porter.
Nice save, Todd.
Rookies seem to be the theme here in this final heat. And here's another, Greg Kenny, who finished third in the Northeast. And another football player. Played linebacker at Northeastern University, 315 pounds. And he will get that and re-racks it on his back.
I mean, I guess that's nice, so you don't have to pick it up later, but wow, I would not expect to do that.
Here's the champ, Rich Froning at 365. Uh-oh, uh-oh, Bill, 365 for the champ.
Now, if we want to look at last year's stuff, you know, coming out of the regionals, he was number two worldwide, right behind Matt Frazier. So he's going to be pushing Matt, and that's exactly what the field didn't want. A good swim and a good lift by Rich. That's deadly on day one.
Scott Panchik is a man who actually pushed Froning at the Central East region. He hits 335, but many people think this man is the heir apparent when Rich Froning bows out of individual competition. Cole Sager, the rookie, yet another 315 pounds.
Solid, so solid.
Kenneth Leverage, three-time CrossFit Games competitor, will close out the first round of this final heat of event number two. Leverage also at 315 pounds.
Man, he makes that look so easy. He is so magical when it comes to any kind of overhead or snatch. It doesn't look like he should be nearly as strong as he is.
Round two begins with Chris Spieler. He was out of the games last year, made it back this year. Seventh time competing at the CrossFit Games. And 275 for Spieler.
Nice job.
He weighs 150 pounds. Will Morad going up by 10 pounds. We'll make a run at 315.
Strong work right there. It's not a problem at all. These guys, I mean, I would expect Will to have jumped up higher than that. That was way too easy. He needs to not be as careful.
Ben Smith at 357 can't hold it overhead. One final lift to go now for Ben Smith, who sits with a score at 345 pounds. Dan Bailey hit 305. Now he's going for 315. And Dan Bailey will hit that. 315 on the board.
That was a great fight by Dan Bailey.
Brandon Swan trying to close out a solid day one here in event two, going for 340 pounds. Cannot hit that one, so Swan will be stuck right now with a score of 320. Here's rookie Noah Olson out of the Southeast at 333 pounds.
See, that's the problem with that snatch bounce. That weight just gets moving down too fast and you aren't controlling it the way you can. If you get it up overhead, lock everything down and then go for that squat.
Josh Bridges for 318 pounds. So Bridges having a much better day one this year than he did last year.
Wow.
That will count, so 318 for Josh Bridges. Troyon missed his first attempt, now going for 295 pounds. Can't make it happen, and almost re-racks the thing, and then it comes crashing to the ground. So now Troyon is in trouble after missing his first two lifts. He won the beach event this morning. Yonikoski, the rookie, at 316. Koski cannot hit that one, so he will stick with a score of 296 heading into his final lift. Todd Porter at 311 pounds. Porter can't get that to happen, so now the failures starting to pile up a little bit here in the second round. Craig Kenny hit 315, now going for 336 pounds. And Kenny will get it, so 336 for the rookie out of the Northeast. Big wait for Rich Froning, looking to tie Matt Fraser in his second lift.
Champ
is on the warpath. 377, and now tied for first place overall in event number two. He finished eighth this morning. He could be on top of the leaderboard after day one. Scott Panchik now at 355 pounds. Panchik led that.
Beautiful lift.
He moves up to 355. Cole Sager increasing by 20 pounds after his first lift at 315. No problem for the former Washington Husky. Final lift of this second round of the final heat. Kenneth Leverage also trying to match Sager at 335 pounds.
Boom.
335 for Leverage heading into the final round. Chris Spieler trying to close out at 290 pounds. This would be a fantastic result for him, but he cannot keep it overhead.
Again, when you put that in perspective, 155-pound body weight, 275-pound successful lift. Unbelievable by Chris Spieler.
Will Morad qualified out of the Central East region, going for 326 pounds. That will count, so Morad closes out with a score of 326, and that leaves Ben Smith up next at 357 pounds. And Ben Smith makes number three count, 357 pounds for Ben Smith.
That keeps him right there in the mix, right in the mix.
Dan Bailey going after 327 pounds. Just a smooth lift for Dan Bailey as he closes out his day at 327. And now Brandon Swan making another run at 340 pounds.
Whoa. That's just a lot of wasted energy going on right there.
He almost battled through it, but Swan could not get that one up. And it's 320 pounds, a final score for Brandon Swan. And now the rookie, Noah Olson, goes for 337, and he makes it happen.
He has that movement down. I would not choose to do it that way, Sean, by any means, but he has that down.
Josh Bridges at 327. Like Chris Spieler, he hits this, a great result for Bridges. just can't hold it.
I think what happened on that one, Sean, he actually blew out on the way down, so he compressed, lost his air.
Final attempt for Jordan Troyon, and he dumps it, and Troyon will not have a successful lift here in event number two. He won the beach event this morning, and a disaster for Jordan Troyon here at the one rep max overhead squat. He will not have a score on the board. Yonikoski on the left side of your screen going for 317 pounds. Good for Koski at 317. Jordan Troyon on the right, clearly upset after what has transpired here as he misses three lifts.
Well, just it's a huge fall from grace from first to smack dab in the middle.
Tom Porter will hit 315. Kurt had talked about it at the top of the show. Fitness means you have to be good at everything. You can't be good at one thing and not the other. Jordan Troyon paying dearly for the fact that he struggles with the overhead squat. Ray Kenny can't hit 350. Now it's the champ as the crowd comes to his feet. 400 pounds on the board for Froning, and that's not going to happen either. But Froning will tie for first. And he could be very well on top of the leaderboard after day number one. Ben Smith and Dan Bailey getting a good laugh after that. But I'm sure Rich Froning, that's going to upset him. And I guarantee you he's going to go home and work on that until he hits it.
He'll probably go and hit it a couple times tonight.
He probably will work out tonight when he gets home.
He probably will.
Scott Panchik at 355 pounds. And a great lift for Scott Panchik. 355. 365 for Panchik. So Panchik right up there in the top five as well. And on Rich Froning's heels. Cole Sanger at 355, battling but can't get out of the hole.
Almost, so close, even rebreathed through there all out, took another big breath and almost got it.
Great showing though for the rookie Cole Sager as Panchik hit 360. Leverage fails at 345 and event two is over, and it's Rich Froning in eighth place and a tie for first with Matt Fraser. Last year Rich Froning had to make a huge charge up the leaderboard starting on Friday. Now Rich Froning could be on top of the leaderboard. But Tommy Hackenbrook will sit in third place in this event, 376.
Everyone is so excited to see him going solo in the mix here just to see if he can really give Rich a run for his money. But so strong. Look at that lift.
It was fun to watch it go back and forth from this end. Matt Fraser, who ties for first.
Everyone was wondering about him as a rookie. Guess what? He's strong, really strong.
Then Rich Froning, his second attempt, besting Fraser by 1 pound, tying Matt Fraser at 377.
This is the last thing that every single other athlete in the field wanted him to have, a good swim and a really good lift. Deadly.
A great day one for the three-time champion. He's standing by live with Amanda Krenz.
So, Rich, you went for 400. Didn't get it. Have you gotten it before?
I've jerked it overhead, and then I've gotten to the bottom of a squat, but I haven't squatted out of it. So I was like, try to use the crowd a little bit and, try to put on a show. So trying to have some fun.
Does it add some pressure when you have these timed lifts?
Yeah, it really does. And especially if you've got a lot of time between. Usually I'm trying to hit a lift every minute or something like that. I like to stay a little bit warmer, so standing around out here. It's a different environment, and it was fun. It was a good time.
What are your overall thoughts after day one? A good showing for you in both events.
Very pleased. Better than I thought it would be, especially at the ocean this morning, so I'll take it.
Yeah. Good job.
I'm
Thanks, Rich.
I'm a hole this year, so that's good.
No, you're not. You started off great.
Thanks.
Rich Froning not climbing out of the hole, but he certainly put some other people in the hole. Matt Fraser and Rich Froning tying for first place. Just 2 pounds separating first from fourth. Jeff Evans, who put up a hell of a score in that first heat. It does not stick, but he's good for fourth. And look at this. After two events, Rich Froning, the three-time champion, is in first place. And then two rookies right behind him, Matt Fraser and Noah Olson, and Scott Panchik sits in fourth.
I just cannot believe that Rich is sitting at the top already. Yes, he's got some great people chasing him down, but when you are already 20 points ahead of the rest of the field, it's a battle for second now.
When Rich Froning says it went better than he thought, that's bad news for everybody else. Remember, the CrossFit Games continue tomorrow with the conclusion of the Masters competition. That competition begins at noon Eastern, 9 Pacific, live on Watch ESPN. Waves and weights, and it's a familiar face for the men on top of the leaderboard. Rich Froning sits in first place. Big weights going up here at the tennis stadium, but it's only day one. Plenty of competition is left. The athletes a day off on Thursday, and the competition resumes on Friday. For Bill Grundler, Amanda Krenz, Rory McKernan, and Tanya Wagner, I'm Sean Woodland, and we'll see you on Friday.